Hello, everybody. I just wanted to take a few minutes to share with you an important decision I'm announcing today. This morning, I nominated our Solicitor General, Elena Kagan, to replace Justice Stevens, who, as you know, is retiring after nearly 35 years on the Supreme Court. Throughout his tenure, Justice Stevens has stood as an impartial guardian of the law, serving with restraint, respect for precedent, and fidelity to the constitutional ideals of equal justice for all. And he has emerged as a consistent voice of reason on the court, helping his colleagues find common ground on some of the most contentious issues of our time. While we can't presume to replace Justice Stevens' wisdom or experience, I believe Elena Kagan embodies that same excellence, independence, integrity, and passion for the law, and can ultimately provide that same kind of leadership on the court. One of our nation's foremost legal minds, Elena is an acclaimed legal scholar with a rich understanding of constitutional law. She's a former White House aide with a firm grasp of the nexus and boundaries between our three branches of government. She's a trailblazing leader, the first woman to serve as Dean of Harvard Law School. And she is a superb Solicitor General, our nation's chief lawyer, representing the American people's interests before the Supreme Court. The first woman in that position as well. She's won accolades from observers across the ideological spectrum for her well-reasoned arguments and commanding presence. But Elena is respected and admired not just for her intellect and record of achievement, but also for her temperament, her openness to different viewpoints, her fair-mindedness, and skill as a consensus builder. As dean, at a time when many believed that the Harvard faculty had gotten a little one-sided in its viewpoint, she sought to recruit prominent conservative scholars and spur a healthy debate on campus. Because she believes, as I do, that exposure to a broad array of perspectives is the foundation, not just of a sound legal education, but of a successful life in the law. But while Elena had a brilliant career in academia, her passion for the law is anything but academic. She's often referred to Supreme Court Justice Thurgood Marshall, for whom she clerked, as her hero. And she credits him with reminding her that, as she puts it, behind law there are stories. Stories of people's lives as shaped by the law. Stories of people's lives as might be changed by law. That understanding of law, not as an intellectual exercise or words on a page, but as it affects the lives of ordinary people, has animated every step of Elena's career. And it is the hallmark of her service as Solicitor General today, working to protect the rights of shareholders against unscrupulous corporations and defending bipartisan campaign finance reform against entrenched special interests. Because in a democracy, powerful interests must not be allowed to drown out the voices of ordinary citizens. Elena's lifelong commitment to public service is unsurprising, given her upbringing. Elena's father was a housing lawyer, devoted to the rights of tenants. Elena's mother was a beloved public school teacher. And at her Solicitor General confirmation hearings, Elena spoke movingly about her mother growing up at a time when women had few opportunities to pursue their ambitions and took great joy in watching her daughter do so. Neither she nor Elena's father lived to see today, but I think she would relish, as I do, the prospect of her daughter, a great lawyer, teacher, and public servant, being nominated to our nation's highest court. I think Elena's mother would also relish, as I do, the prospect of three women taking their seats on the court for the first time in history, a court that will be more inclusive, more representative, and more reflective of us as a people than ever before. I hope that the Senate will act in a bipartisan fashion, as they did in confirming Elena to be our Solicitor General last year, and that they will do so as swiftly as possible so that she can take her seat in time to fully participate in the work of the court this fall. Thanks so much.